Beginning with incoming information tonight from Calaveras County. As you can see here, search crews on hand. Human remains found near the former property of serial killer Wesley Shermantine.
This is an exclusive live look from LiveCopter 3 HD showing some of that rugged terrain near where the bones were found. This is a vantage point you won't see anywhere else. Here's a map giving you a better idea of where they've been searching and continue to search. This is Calaveras County, about 3 miles from the town of San Andreas. We have our full focus on this story tonight.
Let's start with KCRA3's Melinda Meza, who has been at the scene of the search and discovery all day. And Melinda, what are we learning?
Well, we're learning more and more as this story develops. Investigators are still out here, and there still is a search underway as we speak. Now, what investigators can tell us right now is they did find a human skull. They have confirmed that it is indeed a human skull. Now, what is still unanswered is if it belongs to Cindy Vanderheiden, the woman who disappeared from here 13 years ago.
I know it's her, and I'm just glad. And I can't imagine how many more is back there. It's his dumping field.
Neighbors in Calaveras County are reacting to news. Human remains believed to be the victims of convicted killer Wesley Shermantine have been located right here in their neighborhood.
The dog alerted when investigators went over to see what the dog alerted on. They found human remains, and it was a skull.
The sheriff's department has confirmed they found a human skull and bone fragments. This search began early this morning in this rural area near the former Shermantine home. Sacramento County bounty hunter Leonard Padilla says Shermantine sent him a map showing exactly where he left his victims' bodies.
I'm really happy for the families, and I'm sure that if they keep seeking, they'll find more bodies.
Mr. Padilla has been in contact with our investigators as of late. It allowed us to focus in this area.
As you can see, this is a brushy, remote area. The sheriff's department did contact family members of Cindy Vanderheiden, but they say they will have to wait for DNA evidence to confirm it's her.
We're just grateful, in fact, that it is Cindy, that we're able to bring her remains home to her loved ones.
And we can tell you that skull has been turned over to the San Joaquin County Coroner's Office for further investigation. Now, the search is continuing right now. They say there may be more bodies here in this area, but they're not sure just how many. Reporting live here in Calaveras County, I'm Melinda Meza, KCRA 3 Reports.